board approving an amalgamation and also demerger of the radio business. RK Agarwal, CFO of Jagran Prakashan, now joins us. Mr. Agarwal, good afternoon. If you could explain the rationale for both these moves.
Amalgamation of a spectrum and crystal is nothing but to, you know, have the clean structure of ownership of Radio City.
Okay.
Because when we acquired this business, the shareholding was sitting in Spectrum and Crystal, which are 100% subsidiaries of Jagran. So by doing this merger, we are just cleaning up the ownership structure so that, you know, that Jagran directly owns the stake in Radio City instead of through its subsidiaries. So it has got no other relevance whatsoever. There is no issuance of capital or there is no dilution of capital in JPL. The share capital will get cancelled on amalgamation. So this is one part of it. Second is when we acquired Radio City, we had clearly stated that in course of time, the promoter's radio business, which is sitting in Radio Mantra, which is again a profit-making, merely gives 30 to 32% operating margin, will get demerged into Radio City. So taking it forward, that is what we have done today.
Okay, so the radio business will be demerged into another company, is it? And how much will Jagran...
Into Radio City, not in any other company, Radio City. And so that, you know, after this demerger, Radio City will become a network of 39 stations.
Okay, and how much will Jagran own in term, directly own stake in Radio City? How much will that stake be?
Jagran holds 93% stake in Radio City and 7% of Radio City is held by ESOP Trust.
Okay.
Actually, it is 100% ownership of Radio City.
Okay. How big is your radio business now and what kind of numbers is it contributing?
Our radio business, you know, did very well in 2014-15 and it continued to do well in Q1 as well. It recorded the higher than industry's growth rate or the leader's growth rate. And it posted, you know, a turnover of 200 crore in 2014-15 with an operating margin of 31%-32%.
Okay. So those are the numbers so far. But going ahead, say in the next 1 to 2 years, what kind of growth would you expect?
We clearly expect not less than, you know, 15% CAGR growth in the top line and operating margins improving from 31 to 32% to nearly 36-37% in next 2 years time.
Just to understand, the radio business will now be demerged into Radio City. Will you be looking to list this Radio City anytime soon?
I would not rule that out, but currently there is no such plan.
So, okay. So, if you are looking to list, can you give us any indication of a timeline?
No, not really. I did not say, you know, I am looking for listing. But that is something, you know, we have got the radio business only recently.
Yes.
So, we are just settling down there. New stations have come. So, I don't think, you know, there is any immediate plan, you know, to list it.
Okay.
But what I said was, possibility does not, you know, stand ruled out.
Sure. No, okay. So, that point is taken. So, let's not say listing, but any plans to reduce stake from 93% to get some funding, you know, for planning for the next round of expansion?
Again, you know, I mean, like, these things, you know, are not yet, you know, decided. So, very difficult to comment on these things.
All right, Mr. Agarwal, thanks a lot for your time today. So that's Jagran Prakashan, one of the stocks that's flying now. 5.5% higher is what we have on that. We need to take a break. Vinay, stay on with us. We had to address this news. So what we'll do is we'll take a break, come back and discuss the rest of your stocks. As we do that, here's some update on the Maggi issue as well from Karnataka. And we have Maggi may actually get some relief from Karnataka, which is considering lifting the ban on the products.